हेलो गुड मॉर्निंग डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई एम अजित कुमार हियर फ्रॉम क्रिस्त कृपा आश्रम। वेलकम टू गुरुवर्स। दिस मॉर्निंग वी आर गोइंग टू लुक इन टू बुक ऑफ जॉयल चैप्टर 2:28-32। दीस डेज वी वेर लर्निंग फ्रॉम द बुक ऑफ जॉयल। जॉयल मीन्स याहवे एल, यहोवा इज गॉड। सो बुक ऑफ जॉयल गिव्स two different aspects about the day of the Lord. Day of the Lord in retrospect view and day of the Lord in prospect view. The day of the Lord is the day of anger of God. The wrath of God has come upon the people of Judea and their possessions, their prosperities were severely affected by the locusts. That's what I told you yesterday and day before. Now the prophet says, but the forthcoming days will be very severe if you won't repent. So the prophet gives a time to repent and turn to Yahweh. Second chapter yesterday we learned that when the people of God will repent, then God will forgive their sins and God will give lot of blessings to their lives. Whatever they have lost will be recovered, and God will be in the midst of the people of Israel, and God will give all the blessings whichever they have lost. Now 28th verse says, after that the Holy Spirit will come upon them. I will pour out my spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams and your young men shall see visions. Yes, here we see from 28-32, all these verses, we see two things. Importantly, first of all, the Holy Spirit, and the secondly, about the remnant among Israel. That means they will receive both the blessings, their prosperity, that is their physical or social or worldly prosperity, as well as their spiritual prosperity or spiritual blessings. In the Old Testament time, Holy Spirit used to come upon only selected people. Especially, there was exclusion for the work of the Holy Spirit among judges or prophets or kings or priests. But now, afterward, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. No exclusion will be made on the basis of gender, age, or any social status. It readies the people for a new era of oneness. When superficial distinctions are set aside, and even outcast will become core members of God's new fellowship. Here we see two words, flesh and spirit, isn't it? Joel says, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. These two terms are contrast terms. It shows sharp contrast drawn between flesh and spirit. That means extreme weakness of humanity or world we see in flesh. Isaiah 31 verse 3 says, Egyptians are human beings and not God, and their horses are flesh and not spirit. Isaiah chapter 40 verse 6, all flesh is grass, Isaiah says. It takes the outpoured spirit to make the needed difference here. Once Jesus also said in Mark 14:38, flesh or body is weak, but the spirit is ready. Once Paul says in Galatians chapter 3 verse 3, condemning about their faith, saying that you started in spirit, but now you are ending in flesh. So spirit and flesh shows the sharp contrast. Now God says, if you return to God, if you come and repent, God will give you the spirit, and he will pour out his spirit upon all flesh, even though you are in a extreme human position, having all kinds of weakness. God is ready to restore you, strengthen you, and bring you back to the original form in which you were created. You see, religion is flesh, but Christ is spirit. First Adam, in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, 45 to 48, we see, first Adam was flesh, but the last Adam, who was Jesus Christ, is spirit. When Peter preached in the day of Pentecost, he quoted from the same paragraph, which is written in Acts chapter 2, 16 to 20. Peter says, it is just like, or it's the fulfillment of prophet Joel spoke. So my dear friends, this is not only an experience coming upon your pouring out of the Holy Spirit. It's not merely an experience, but here Joel speaks about an era, about a dispensation, about a new history. That's what started in the day of Pentecost, that history of the church, a new era of the Holy Spirit. So here, when Holy Spirit will come, what will happen? Holy Spirit will come, everything will be changed. There will be no discrimination. And a new people, a new body will be formulated. That is also speaking about the eschatological vision. That's what we read in the 32nd verse. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem, there shall be those who escape or save, as the Lord has said, and among the survivors shall be those whom the Lord calls. So at last, there will be God's remnant. That is called the remnant. So two things are mentioned here in the 32nd verse. The first one is salvation. Second one is the remnant of God. So my dear friends, in short, I want to tell you this morning, when we come back to God, when we repent, what will happen? Even God is ready to pour out his spirit upon all the flesh. All the situations will be changed, and there will be an ultimate transformation, a complete transformation, which is going to be given by Almighty God. So here also we see a great call for our transformation or repentance. All flesh will be turned to spirit without any discrimination, and God keeps a remnant for him in all the time. Shall we pray? Gracious Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord, for this wonderful day you have given to us. Father God, we pray that these days everyone be turned to you, Lord. The church, the nation, the whole world will turn to you and seek the face of the Lord. Father God, I pray for all the brothers and sisters, those who are listening to this message this morning, wherever they may be, Lord. Father God, everyone will see the glory of God, and everyone will receive the outpouring of the Holy Spirit in their lives. Thank you, Lord, for listening to our prayers. And we know that when the flesh will receive the Spirit of the Lord, everything will be changed. We are always weak, and we are away from God. We are like a flesh. But Lord, we know that when you will pour out your spirit upon us, yes, Lord, we also will be changed to a new nation in a new dispensation. So we pray for all the brothers and sisters having different kinds of prayer subjects or issues today, this morning. We pray for them. We intercede for them. Father God, everyone be blessed this morning, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for listening to our prayers. We give all the glory to you. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen and amen. May God bless you, my dear friends. Till we meet again tomorrow. Bye-bye. Take care. God.